at the right time, and also to have information at our fingertips so that informed decisions can be made, then a fleet maintenance management system, a computerized, is a must. A good fleet maintenance management system will result in reduction in downtime because of high availability and better equipment efficiency. Lifetime extension, reduction in labor costs, reduction in spare parts storage, etc. At least 10 to 20% of the annual maintenance budget reduction will be realized with a good computerized fleet management system. Fleet inventory tracking. This is a database. We need to establish for each vehicle, the sections and the individuals to whom the vehicles are assigned, all specification, descriptive details, year, make, model, serial number, VIN number, etc., 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 and reports generated. There is a database that should be available to managers, senior managers, everybody who needs this information. Inventory management. Before I even talk inventory, let me explain something about modern maintenance that we have implemented here. It's one thing that we modern maintenance is based on availability, availability, availability. It's not just to repair or replace broken down equipment. It's keeping the equipment available for use at all times. So availability can be measured. The performance of availability can be measured. That's what it's all about for modern maintenance. Keep your equipment free, available for use at all times. Now, available performance is broken down into three parts for measurements and calculations. I'll just give you a idea what the definitions are. It's not enough. Reliability is based on three parts. First one is reliability performance, and it is defined as the ability of an item under stated conditions of use to perform a required function under stated conditions for a stated period of time. And it is a measure of mean time to failure. It's abbreviated MTTF, and it's the mean time between equipment failure. It is dependent entirely on the techniques, the system, the maintenance plan, the program, the structure, the system, what you have in place to care of the maintenance, right? Secondly, is the maintainability performance. Now, maintainability performance is defined as the ability of an equipment under stated condition of use to be returned and restored to a state in which it can perform a required function when maintenance is performed under stated conditions using stated procedures and resources. It is a measure of the mean time to repair, and it's totally equipment dependent. That means that one of the things we need to look at when you're procuring equipment is maintainability performance. Last but not least, and this is where we're falling down, it's called maintenance support performance. It is defined as the ability of a maintenance organization under stated conditions to provide upon demand the resources required to maintain an equipment. It is a measure of the mean waiting time, and it is abbreviated MWT. It is also the average waiting time for maintenance resources when a stoppage is occurred or a failure is identified. It is totally dependent on the organization, and this is where we are falling down. We need to be able to provide, upon demand, the resources that we need. And we cannot ensure availability if it without an inventory management system. We cannot ensure that the resources are available unless we have an inventory management system. If you're going to order materials when they are needed, we ain't going to do a good job. We cannot ensure equipment availability, and that is what maintenance is all about, modern maintenance. Right? Inventory management is critical to the success of a fleet maintenance management system. We must be able to provide, upon demand, the resources required to maintain our fleet of vehicles. The largest contribution to equipment vehicle downtime is waiting time. That is the time spent waiting for materials and parts needed to complete a maintenance job and repairs. In maintenance management, it is called wasting time because it's totally organization dependent. It depends on personnel organization. It depends on all levels of management and includes accounts and finance. We need to ensure the Ministry of Finance knows what we are doing, what are the resources and we need, what are the benefits to the country and the government, and when the resources are to be dispersed. That is critical, and this is where we are failing, and we need to maybe have some meetings with the Ministry of Finance let them know what is it that we are doing. I don't think they have a clue about what we are doing. So they need to know what we are doing, they need to support us, they need to provide upon demand the resources we need to keep our equipment available at all times. In maintenance manual, I said that it's in an inventory management system with standard operating procedures, documentation and accountability is absolutely necessary if we are to keep vehicles available for use at all times. Is it that we set up one inventory management system, or we're going to work out an agreement with suppliers for they to supply us with the resources that we need, the parts we need, the materials we need when upon demand when we need it. But something has to be done. We cannot operate how we are right now if we are going to ensure that the vehicles are available, our equipment are available for use at all times. Totally impossible. Servicing. Each unit of the fleet should be serviced at a stipulated intervals. The intervals will be determined by the manufacturer's recommendation, the use of the vehicle, the working environment, historical data, or similar units. The mileage will be used to determine the intervals. So normally, 5,000 kilometers, 5,000 miles, each vehicle must be serviced within that. And I mean service, good service, not just changing oil and filter. The fleet management system will generate service orders for each unit. Color-coded preventative maintenance alert reports will be generated. Equipment due for service will be shaded red. Equipment soon to be serviced will be shaded yellow. Servicing of units would include, but not limited to, systematic inspection of the unit, including the outside, underneath the hood, underneath the vehicle, inside the cab. Inspection of components having high rate of wear or deterioration are probably need of frequent adjustments. These include oil and filter change, additional of transmission oil and hydraulic fluid, clutch adjustment, engine running condition, adjustment to meet manufacturer's recommendation, also included are front end alignment, transmission service, hydraulic filters, engine tune-ups, and drivetrain adjustment. The service is not just changing oil and filter, it's a lot more than that. And save servicing saves money. When you service a vehicle, don't break down on the road. It saves money. Upon completion of service work, orders should be completed and returned to transport department, the section, right, where the system update should be done. Objective condition-based monitoring. This is to be done by skilled mechanics using instruments. When failures develop, you cannot pick it up with the naked eye. Normally, when you pick it up with the naked eye, it's when it's about to come to a close or breakdown. You need instruments that can fix up these failure developments. Electronic control modules should be used to control engine timing and injection system, anti-lock brakes and airflow sensors. Electronic measurement and diagnostic equipment should be used to perform a variety of tests and adjustments during PM inspection to keep the equipment operating satisfactorily while reducing downtime and optimizing fuel use. Other instruments that can be another for the instrument that you can use to assist with the inspections. Some of the items to be inspected include the brakes, your starter, your charging system, your windshield wipers, gauges, mirrors, seat belts, suspension, horn, light, exhaust sensors, air system, tires, hydraulic, battery, cooling system, drivetrain, steering, windows, etc. All that inspection needs to be done on the vehicle. When inspections are completed, the work orders are returned to the department that is transport, where the necessary documentation and follow-up are done. Plan corrective maintenance and repairs. When preventative maintenance inspections are done and a failure development identified, then corrective maintenance work should be planned and work order generated to correct the problem before a costly and timely breakdown occurs. A computerized diagnostic equipment can be used to troubleshoot a malfunctioning vehicle and diagnose the problems and causes. This is technology. We need to use the technology. There are computerized diagnostic equipment that are available now that just scan your vehicle and it tells everything that's going on with the vehicle. Mechanics don't have to do diagnosis by elimination anymore. We have the technology available. Why are we not using it? I am strongly recommending that the transport and garage procure at least two of these diagnostic equipment, they save a lot of time, they save a lot of money. And until they pay back yourself in 1 week, you get back that money. So we need to do that. We need to invest in this computerized diagnosis equipment. That's it. Also, we provide historical data to tell you what happened to your vehicle 3 months back, 6 months back. You can tell how your vehicle is performing. We need to utilize this technology that is there for to make us more productive, smart, and efficient. History recording. Documentation is important. We don't do a lot of documentation here, but we need to be keeping records and doing documentation. When maintenance activities are performed on the fleet, all the pertinent details should be documented. A preventative and corrective maintenance history should be generated for each vehicle, listing all of the maintenance work performed on that your vehicle, including costs, preventive maintenance repairs, parts, labor, and more. The historical data will be used to analyze costs, monitor trends in wear, neglect and abuse of the vehicle, and establish the cost effectiveness of each vehicle in the fleet. And you change a vehicle when it is costing you more to own and operate it than the benefits you're getting from it. That's effective management. Fuel monitoring. Monitoring of fuel consumption should be a critical part of the program. All fuel transactions should be documented and reports generated. The MPG for each vehicle should be checked at each transaction. Operators should be required to document at the odometer reading the quantity of fuel received at all transactions. Head of department should be required to generate and submit a monthly tabulated report, and we have shown the tabulated report that is required. That already showed in our earlier slide. All pertinent information on the use of the vehicle should be documented and monthly reports generated. Parts inventory. All parts used on the fleet should be documented, itemized, price, and part usage report generated. For each vehicle, you must have a history to show repairs that were carried out, the materials you use, the parts you use. And at the end of the month, you can give you a cost. Labor cost, material cost for that vehicle, what it costing us to own and operate that vehicle. Flexible reporting. Reporting should be one of the important aspects of the program. Weekly, monthly, quarterly, and annual reports should be generated from simple fleet listing to complicated periodical cost and analysis reports that can be generated and made available to all managers and heads of department. Life cycle cost analysis. Life cycle cost analysis, which is the total cost associated with owning and operating an equipment or a vehicle during the lifetime of the vehicle, should be used to do all procurement as the most cost-effective purchases are done. Budget. An annual budget should be prepared for the department. This budget should reflect the cost of our maintenance program that will be used to realize our objectives. Budget is important, and not only budget, the cash flow is even more important. License and insurance of fleet. Well, this is not necessary because it's licensed and insured at once per annum, and all vehicles are insured at the same time. So this will not apply to us. Communication with vehicle operators are essential in a fleet management system for obvious reasons. So you must have communication. Somebody out, I'm driving a government vehicle to be able to communicate with base at any point in time. That's the end of the presentation.